This video will explain why the locations were chosen for the building of castles, with particular focus on Norman castle building in Wales. Last lesson, we discovered that raiding attacks from Vikings and Huns in particular galvanised lords into building defensive structures to protect their land, people and possessions. The location of these defensive structures was by no means an accident. It was a key part of their sophisticated protective design and decided by four important factors. In order to understand these, let's take a close look at the Norman conquest of England and a building we sometimes take for granted, Chepstow Castle. The Norman conquest of England wasn't complete with the death of Harold Godwinson at the Battle of Hastings. It was a long process of implementing control over revolt and rebellion. Incidentally, the most bloody scenes of which were seen in the north of England during the so-called Harrying of the North, described by another famous Harry here.
Hogwater oil. Now here's a Harry question. Why does the Doomsday Book contain so many empty villages in Yorkshire?
Is it called the Harrowing of the North?
The Harrying. It's like a harrowing, but it's the Harrying.
My understanding of it is that there was basically, in the city of York, there was an uprising against the Norman troops that were there. And then basically all the people in the city kind of realised that they were actually vastly outnumbering those. But then I think there was a decree sent by the king after this uprising happened, and everything was burnt from sort of like 100
you
miles.
You should have got the salient points. Yes, William the Bastard, as he was known. Don't be put off by a young person knowing more than you are.
The invasion had created a temporary power vacuum and the potential for rich pickings if neighbouring kingdoms could exploit the situation. Wales at the time was made up of a collection of independent micro-kingdoms with little allegiance to either Anglo-Saxons or Normans. In order to prevent the Welsh kings from raiding down into his newly conquered farmlands, William set about building a chain of fortifications through an area known as the Welsh Marches, in other words, the border between England and Wales, as you can see here. The first of these was Chepstow Castle, begun in 1067 by Norman Baron William FitzOsborne. Chepstow was chosen because of its strategic location at the neck of the River Wye as an important crossing point. Building a castle here would protect the road east of Gloucester and some of England's richest farmlands. So the first reason to determine the location of a castle was having something to protect. The second factor in choosing a location was equally important, making sure it was somewhere easy to defend. Chepstow Castle, as you can see here, is built on a narrow ridge with a high vantage point overlooking the river and countryside. High, jagged limestone cliffs on one side prevent any attack. Importantly, the river running below would act as both a water source and as a sewage system during a long siege. Interestingly, Chepstow Castle was originally called Strigul, derived from the Welsh Ustrail, meaning a river bend. To the south and east of the castle is a low valley, known as the Dell, meaning that attacks from that direction would be facing uphill. The least defensible side of the castle is the northwest. As a result, here is where it is strongest. The large, looming keep would have been a formidable target. Chepstow is a fairly early example of castle building. As the centuries progressed, the defences of castles became more and more sophisticated. The castle you can see here is a 13th century Cracht du Chevalier, built to protect the Crusaders in the Holy Land from Saracen attacks. But I'm getting ahead of myself. I'm explaining the reasons why castles were built where they were. The third factor in choosing the location of a castle was communication. If the castle was to be the home of a lord, then he would need ready access to any word from his king, to be able to spread news, to muster forces quickly in case of an attack, and to have a good means of safe transportation of taxes and goods. In this sense, Chepstow's location directly on the River Wye is ideal. Rivers were the fastest means of communication, and from Chepstow messages could be sent north to Monmouth or across the Severn to Bristol within a day. Finally, in order to build a castle in any location required a huge amount of stone. With its abundance of limestone deposits, Chepstow is again an ideal setting. Furthermore, there's even evidence that stone blocks used in Chepstow Castle were taken from the ruins of the Roman town at Caerwent. So, in summary, there are four factors to assess when deciding where to build your castle. Firstly, something to protect, a town, border or strategically important location. Secondly, a well-defensible site, perhaps a hill or river bend. Thirdly, easy communication via road, river or sea. And finally, plenty of stone. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to follow @ChepstowHistory on Twitter or at our blog on chepstowschoolhistory.blogspot.co.uk.